What's going on, dudes? My name is Prestige. Welcome to episode number 45 of a series that I like to call Elite Weapons of Advanced Warfare. In this series, we take a look at elite variations of weapons you'll earn in your supply drops while playing through Call of Duty Advanced Warfare. I let you know whether or not those weapons are worth keeping or scrapping for the 2000 XP. If you happen to miss any of the other 44 episodes, I'll make sure to have a complete playlist linked down below in the description and in the form of a card, which you can find on your screen right now. But without further ado, let us get into today's episode. We are going to be covering the one, the only, the M1 Irons Unforgiving Truth. A lot of you have been waiting for this episode, and honestly, I've been waiting to post this episode, and I absolutely got lucky with one of my regular supply drops, got this pistol, and I'm really happy that I did, because now this is going to be the second half of Elite Weapons that we're going to be covering. So the other M1 Irons has already been covered. If you want to check out that episode, it will be linked down below in the playlist. So let us get started. Talking about the bad first, there is a few things that are happening with this weapon that you can correct to a degree. One of those things being mobility is decreased. Now, what the decrease in mobility is going to do is it's going to make your aim down sight speed a little bit slower. So you're going to notice it definitely, but if you're like me and always run the quick draw handle, this will be canceled out completely. You're going to have a faster draw rate than you normally would with the base version M1 Irons, and that's something that you really won't have to worry about. Next up, you're going to notice that there is a fire rate decrease. This is pretty self-explanatory. Your fire rate is going to be decreased. If you're like me while using this weapon, I love to fire it in 3-round bursts. Just in case somebody's right around the corner, I have another 3 rounds to dispose into another enemy. But with this particular weapon, it almost has like an artificial slowdown. So if you sat there, took your hand off the aiming, and tried to spam the trigger and shoot as fast as you can, you'll notice that there's some sort of like artificial slowdown, and it makes it so you can't really fire as fast as you want. But if you fire it normally by just pulling the trigger over and over and over again, it almost feels like it fires faster, and that's pretty interesting to say the least. Finally, we have a damage decrease, and now what this is going to do, this is going to make it so you get a lot more 4-shot kills pretty much. So if you're at a longer range, you're going to get 4-shot kills, but most of the time what you're going to see is a lot of 2- and 3-shot kills, depending on if the enemy was already hurt and depending on how far you are away. So let's move into the good. What are the redeeming factors of this weapon? We actually have a range increase. This range increase is basically going to extend that range of your 3-shot kill. Once again, if you are at a super long range, that 4-shot kill is pretty much going to be the most annoying factor of this weapon. We also have a handling increase. This is going to increase, or actually decrease, the size of your hip fire spread. So you're going to have a tighter hip fire spread overall. This is a good weapon to use while akimbo. If you really wanted to go that extra mile, you could throw on the laser sight like I have in this gameplay. That way you're still able to have that added accuracy while aiming down sight to pick off enemy at super long ranges. But once again, that's when that 4-shot kill is going to come into play here. So if you're one of those people that likes to run and gun super close range, akimbo is definitely the way to go with this particular variant. And finally, speaking more about accuracy, that has been buffed as well with this particular variant. Accuracy is going to be a little bit better. You'll notice that there's not as much recoil, but once again, the M1 Irons doesn't have that much recoil to begin with, so no matter what variant you're using, you're not really going to notice the difference between this one and the base variant overall. So you can pretty much just cancel out this accuracy thing. It's not a big deal overall. It's one of those weapons where if you wanted to use this for the looks in particular, because it is a very nice looking variant, you definitely can. It's really not too hurtful on what you're doing, but there are a lot more stronger variants out there, if that makes sense. This is overall the most accurate variant that you can get, and this is how I have it set up every single time. Quick draw handle, advanced rifling, and I also like to use the laser sight, just so I can hip fire just in case it comes down to that. Like if I have to go for the final kill and I know somebody's directly in front of me, I absolutely want to be able to make sure that I can pick off that enemy before they pick me off. And with the M1 Irons, it's kind of like having a portable old school MK14, if you think of it that way, just with a lot less rounds. It's kind of like a semi-automatic sniper rifle, if you think of it that way as well. You can get super easy kills at close range, really nice kills at longer ranges, not with this particular variant, but with other variants. And I think overall, it's just a really cool weapon to use. I think that it was an awesome addition as DLC. And speaking more about DLC, we're going to have the AK-47, the SEL-3 cauterizer, and the M16 assault rifle being added very, very soon, which I will be covering all three of those weapons. Make sure to stay tuned to the channel by clicking that subscribe button. As for the M1 Irons Unforgiving Truth, I want to give it my seal of approval. I think it looks cool. Absolutely love it in game. And even though it might have its downsides, I still find it one of my favorite variants to use in a free-for-all while akimbo because it just makes people's minds go crazy when you win a free-for-all with something like the M1 Irons. But I want to thank you guys so much for watching today's video. I definitely have more Black Ops 3 gameplay on the way, so stay tuned for all of that. I'm just saving it for darker times, more or less October, the darker month when there's really not too much going on with Advanced Warfare and we're waiting for Black Ops 3 to come out. So I'll have more gameplay coming up soon. Don't fret, guys. We got more Advanced Warfare videos on the way. We are not done here with the Elite Weapons series, but I want to thank you all so much for watching today's video. If you enjoyed, make sure to click the thumbs up button down below, and do not forget to subscribe for more awesome videos each and every day. We are so close to 600,000 subscribers, guys. Thank you so much for subscribing, and until next time, I am out. Peace.